Hello, I'm M.K. Davis. What you're looking at is one of the photos that was came to me out of Siberia. That was sent to me by some Russian colleagues, Igor Bortsev in particular. And this is after I enhanced it and enlightened it. And you can, this was formerly very dark, and now you can see quite a bit of detail. And, in doing so, you see some curious features about it. I spoke about in a previous segment on this, the hair being sort of translucent. You can see, the way the sun strikes this, the sheen, which is, if you could ever get some of the hair to study, I think you would find that it's remarkable. Now, this is particularly, there's another feature that I really wanted to go ahead and get to. People have, highlighted and talked about, and I saw it immediately when I first saw the enlightened version or the brightened version. So let me just kind of, blow it up a little bit right here. Okay, here you see, the blonde hair streaming, kind of blondish, reddish blonde hair streaming back, but you see a bright spot of red right there, kind of dead center of the back between the shoulder blades right there. And that became a question. I've noticed, over the years that when Americans analyze something, and Americans, they love to have their analysis, Johnny on the spot, 30 seconds or less, and then you go on. The Europeans, the Russians, tend to give it more time and a little more thought. Now, this is the assumption made by a gentleman, here in the States. When he first saw it, he says that, well, that's the back of the neck of the individual as he's hoaxing this. That's his neck exposed out from under the cap or whatever, the hoodie. And that took about 10 seconds to say, and that was it. He didn't even go the full 30 seconds. So I wanted to kind of address this a little bit, because I've seen it in other frames as well. So, let me just kind of zoom in on it a little bit. I can't spend too much time on it because we got to move on. The video can't be that long. Let's go ahead and get out of this. And let's go to another one of the photos that where I saw this at. Okay, here it is. Now, what I'm going to do is first I'm going to brighten it first before we zoom in. And I discussed this, how to do this earlier, so I'm just kind of going to go on through this very fast if I can. Right. All right, we got recovered most of our color. Now let's zoom in. It should be a much brighter and easier to look at. Up in those shadows. There you go. Okay, this is our subject in question. Let me come out of the zoom. I think I already have. Okay. There he is. He's still hunched way over. That's the face pointing down. This is some streamers of that blondish hair. Now, there you see that red again, right there. And it's not in the same position. It's moved over to the side. So it's not something on the body, attached to the body. It's attached to the hair. So we'll just kind of jack up the contrast. Now you can see it. It's not, this is something around a lock of hair. You see this hair coming off the back of the neck right here, goes down here, and it becomes a little more blonder, or a little reddish blonde at the ends. And it's tying the hair. It's what it's doing. It's ornamental. It's functional. It's something red. You know, whether it's leather, I don't know. Whether it's a vine, I don't know. Whether it's string, I don't know. But it's something that he has tied this lock of hair, where it was formerly back on the neck, because he's bent way over, it's laying over to the side. So, see, it is, it's tying this long lock of hair that is reddish blonde on the end. And, there you go. That's why I say, you know, you have to give it more than 30 seconds. You have to look at it very closely. Now, this individual was in a seated position. So, you know, that's not unheard of if you look into the lore, legends and lore of the Almasty. They sleep squatted down with their arms folded and their face in their folded arms. Now, you can see that right here. Let me find it. See? Right here. It's coming out of that folded position right there. And it's waking up, apparently. Apparently that's what's going on. So they've disturbed it. It's coming out of its sleep. And that's further borne out by this right here. I'll show you. I need to go to second batch photos animated. Here we go. And I'll run this in Windows Explorer. Internet Explorer. There we go. Watch the guy. You'll see that he's wandering around. This is the second batch of photos. See, he comes out from here, goes toward the camera, then he goes back over here, and he goes back down that way. He's confused. You can see where he runs into this limb right here and knocks a whole bunch of snow off of it. See, it's still flying in the air. It indicates that this person just came up out of a sleep. Now, there's some other photos that further bear that out. Let me get out of this and go back to let's see, this one right here. If you'll look right here, you'll see the hair. Then this is the front, and the reason I know it's the front is because the feet are pointed this way. So here we go. It's got a few. See the hair is swept back this way, back up over the head. It's had its face or its head buried in its own arms. It's been squatting down with arms folded, with its head buried up in its own, in its chest, and amongst the arms, and it's been that way for a while to mold that hair back like that. It's disturbed. It got up. It was confused. It ran a couple of different directions, and then this is the photo here where it gets a little angry and snaps this tree off right here, and it breaks it off, a pretty good sized tree, and you can see that down here at the bottom, you know, there's the piece that he broke off. You know, they say that it's bad medicine to wake up a sleeping Almasty. If you see one sleeping, back away. That's what they say. Or if you wake it up, you could end up either hurt right then and there, or and the legend has that it's bad luck to boot, that bad things will happen to you. And I know that two of the people involved in this that took some of these photos here are now dead. They died in an automobile accident. Well, is it connected? I don't know. But they say, don't wake up a sleeping Almasty. The easiest thing is, don't wake him up. They're not nice. I thank you for your time.